Welcome back to this next lecture where we look at the stiffness in a transverse direction for a composite. So transverse to the file direction. So we will draw our model of our composite again. So with this square block. Separate it up into a fiber part and a matrix part. The fiber part, we will have a stiffness, which we call EF, and the matrix part, we have the stiffness EM. And again, like last time, we have a certain amount of fibers, which can be quantified with this area of the fiber, and then we have a certain amount of matrix, which we can quantify with this area of the matrix. So now we can put a load on this one. So now we load transverse to the fiber direction, so we will load in this direction here with a P. That will make this block expand in a transverse direction. So so we will have the new surface up here and down here. And then actually in an assumption here, or in the model here, we are assuming a uniaxial stress state. So actually we should allow that the matrix can contract differently than the fiber, which normally will be much stiffer. So probably will look like something like this. So here we can identify that that the fiber, which from the start have the thickness TF, will now be elongated with this element here, which we can call delta TF. And similar, we have that the matrix will, which have the thickness from the start, TM, now will be elongated with this part here, which we call delta TM. So so when we look at the loads in the thickness direction of this one, then we have that the load, the total load working in a fiber must be equal to the total load working in a matrix. So we have that the load P is equal to the load in a matrix, which are equal to the load in the fiber. So this is also, and then we can see initially that we have the same cross section of the two say parts here in the transverse direction. So therefore this corresponds also to that we can say that the stress in a transverse direction is equal to the stress in a matrix, which are equal to the stress in a fiber, which are called also the voice assumption, which are ISO stress state in our material system. So now we can try to derive the equation for the straining, the total straining of this material here. So the total strains, so first we need to put up a definition of a strain. The definition of a strain is delta L over L, meaning that here in the thickness direction, that the strain in the transverse direction is equal to the change in the thickness, which are delta TF plus delta TM, divided by TF plus TM, which are the initial thickness of our composite here. So then we can separate this into two terms, saying that delta Tf divided by Tf plus Tm plus delta Tm divided by Tf plus Tm. Now we can look a little into this, you could say, the relation between the Tf and Tm, and then the individual part of it. So we have that if we want to write the fiber volume fraction, Vf, that can then be put equal to Tf divided by the total thickness, Tm plus Tf. And that can, we can then isolate the 1 over Tm Tf, which are the term here, meaning that 1 over Tm plus Tf is equal to Vf divided by Tf. And similar, we can write that Vm is equal to the same derivation here, meaning that 1 over Tm plus Tf is equal to Vm divided by Tm. So we can, in this part here, replace the 1 over Tm Tf with the Vf divided by Tf. And over here, we can take the other part here. So we can write that epsilon T is equal to so replace this with this one. So we have Vm delta Tm, so now I took this part here, divided by Tm. So that's this part here, which are putting in instead of this term here. And then we have the other part here, Vf delta Tf divided by Tf. So now we can look at the definition of the strain again. So the definition of strain is delta L over L. So we actually here have that this is the change of thickness of the matrix part divided by the initial thickness of that and the thickness change in thickness of the fiber part divided by the initial thickness of this one. So we can write that then that this one is equal to Vm epsilon m plus Vf epsilon f. So now we can use, you could say, the definition for stresses, the relation between strain and stress, meaning that the strain is equal to the stress divided by E. So we can replace this one by the stresses in a fiber matrix divided by the stiffness of a matrix, and this one stresses in a fiber divided by the stiffness of the fiber. So we have that epsilon T is equal to Vm sigma m divided by Em plus Vf sigma f divided by the stiffness of the matrix material. So now we can use this relation up here, that the stress in a fiber and a matrix are equal to the total stress, or the stress in transverse direction. So we can write this one as Vm 1 over Em plus Vf 1 over Ef multiplied with the stress in a transverse direction. So then we have that epsilon t, so the strain in a transverse direction, is also equal to the stress in a transverse direction divided by the stiffness in a transverse direction, which are the one we would like to calculate. So this one is equal to 1 over et multiplied with sigma in t direction. So now we can remove this part here and identify this part here is equal to the 1 over the stiffness in the transverse direction. So in total, we can write this as 1 over et equal to Vm 1 over Em plus Ef 1 over Ef, which are also called the inverse rules of mixture. So, thank you.